Welcome back. The number of adults with dementia is expected to increase in future decades, and recent discoveries have shown that good hearing is closely tied to keeping your mind sharp and agile. Last summer, a study found this remarkable connection. So joining us with more information on one of the study's principal investigators, Dr. Vicky Sanchez from the University of South Florida. And Dr. Sanchez, you know, this is something that has been proven over and over again in recent years about how important it is to make sure you get your hearing checked.
Yeah, that's absolutely correct. I mean, good hearing is good health and well-being.
And talk a little bit about the connection when it comes to hearing loss and then dementia. What are you seeing that makes this so clear?
Yeah, there's lots of evidence that has been building over the decades connecting those with hearing loss have an increased risk of developing dementia. And some of that is still trying to figure it out, but what we think might be happening is that hearing loss causes cognitive load, making it hard for your brain to process the sound, making you have mental fatigue, all of which might be negatively affecting the brain. In addition, hearing loss also changes brain structure and function, and lastly, hearing loss is known to decrease social networks, making people wanting to go out and about in social settings less often, all of which would have a negative effect on the brain. So the thought process is if we treat the hearing loss, such as the use of a hearing aid, that we would decrease cognitive load, support healthy brain structure and function, and also increase those social connections and opportunities, all of which would have a positive impact on the brain.
You know, we've seen several studies supporting this, this newest one that you're talking about. You know, I want to go to, I'm at the age where I have parents who are starting to enter this time where I hear a lot of, what'd you say? And so I always say, listen, this can be connected to dementia. But the first thing is they don't want to wear a hearing aid. Can you tell someone out there watching how far they've come in the advancements of hearing aids, and you can barely even see them in their ear right now? What plea would you make to those people out there saying, I'm not doing it?
Yeah, hearing aids are available today are nothing like what you think about them from 10, 15, 20 years ago. They're super micro technology, advanced computers right on the level of your ears, very small, sleek, not very noticeable, and they do a wonderful job of not only bringing sounds louder so you can have access to them, but also allowing you to connect to things that you want to listen to, connect directly to your cell phone or to the television and so forth. They truly do a wonderful job of making those sounds able to get to your brain and then give your brain some relief to better understand what's being said.
And what is being done in doctors' offices around the country at this point, now knowing this connection?
Well, there's a lot more awareness that healthy hearing is really important. And so there's more doctors are asking about hearing or referring on patients to get their hearing evaluated. And more so, we're actually asking patients as well to advocate for their own hearing. If they have any concern, to reach out to their primary care to start that conversation as well.
There are so many things we don't know about dementia. So if this is one thing that we do know that we can potentially kind of help and control to some extent, it seems like a no-brainer. All right, thank you so much for that information, for talking more about this study. If you'd like to know more about this connection, and of course, the studies that are out there, we put a link on our website, WPBF.com.